Diamonds are forever. Yeah, maybe. Depends on what you mean by forever. Theorems. Theorems are forever and ever. Take Pythagoras' theorem. That is true even if Pythagoras himself is dead. Even if the world ends whenever there are two nice legs on the right angle and a good hypotenuse, Pythagoras' theorem will work. We mathematicians do theorems, eternal truths. But it's not always easy to know what is an eternal truth, a theorem, and what is just a conjecture. We need an actual proof. Imagine that we have an infinite plane and we want to cover it with identical pieces, leaving no gaps. We can use squares, we can use triangles. Sorry, madam, we cannot use circles, they leave gaps. What is the best piece to use? The one that covers a given surface with the smallest boundary. Papus of Alexandria, in year 300, said the best thing was to use hexagons, like bees do. But he couldn't prove it. It was just a conjecture, Papus' conjecture. The world then divided between papists and anti-papists until 1,700 years later, Thomas Hales gave an actual proof that papus and the bees were right. So it became a theorem, the honeycomb theorem. We will last forever, forever and ever, more than any diamond. But what if we go to three dimensions? How to fill the space with identical pieces, leaving no gaps? We can use cubes. Sorry, madam, we cannot use spheres. They leave gaps. What is the best piece to use? Lord Kelvin, the degree Kelvin guy, more than 100 years ago said the best thing was to use a truncated octahedron. Like, as everybody knows, is this piece here. But he couldn't prove it. It was just a conjecture. Kelvin's conjecture. The world then divided between Kelvinists and anti-Kelvinists. Until more than 100 years later, Warian Felon, found a better structure. This little pretty thing here, to which they gave the groundbreaking name of Warian-Felon structure. Looks strange, but not that strange. It's funny, it was used to construct the aquatic center in the Olympic Games in Beijing. There, Michael Phelps won 8 gold medals, becoming the best swimmer of all time. Of all time until a better one shows up. The same thing happens to the Warian-Felon structure. But this one has the chance that someone, maybe in 100 years, maybe 1,700 years, gives an actual proof that this is the best possible piece. And it will become a theorem, forever and ever. People in discrete geometry are trying to solve this problem. Some trying to give the actual proof. Some try to find a better piece. Sorry, madam. No one succeeded yet. So if you want to tell someone that you love them forever, give them a diamond, that's okay. But if you want to tell them that you love them forever and ever, give them a theorem. But you'll have to prove it. Don't let your love be just a conjecture.
Thank you for a nice talk. I'm glad that this year we have a few mathematicians here. I wonder, what is your field of research in maths?
My field of research is computational algebra and geometry. We try to do computers do abstract math and prove these kind of conjectures, theorems, and find optimal forms, optimal ways to do things.
So which conjecture that's still outstanding would you most like to solve or find the theory underpinning?
The Goldbach conjecture. That's an incredible one.
And can you tell us why?
Yeah, it's easy. Maybe you can try yourself at home if you're bored. We had a presentation here about prime numbers. Everybody, most of you may know what a prime number is. So the conjecture says every even number, 2, 4, 6, is the sum of 2 primes. Prove it. No one could so far. It's proven for numbers of 10,000 digits. But maybe a higher number fails the conjecture. No one knows that. Try at home. It's funny.
So is this what you're going to spend your life doing?
I love it. Yes. Yes, I love it. But what could be more fun? Yeah, but since it's so funny, I also run and do other things just to keep my mind in fit.
Thank you. Be glad you've caught him in his prime. Eduardo Ferns de Cabathon.